If you're a small engine mechanic and you own a compression tester, there's a very good chance it's giving you wildly inaccurate readings. In today's short video, I'm going to explain why this is the case, why it's so common, and a quick, easy DIY fix that you can do yourself at home. Whenever you buy a compression tester, it must have a low pressure Schrader valve in the adapter that threads directly into the cylinder head. Yet oftentimes the automotive kits that we buy don't have them, and therefore the hose itself acts as additional cylinder volume, giving you a much lower compression reading than what your engine actually has. Before I show you the fix, I've got two identical compression test hoses and adapters, yet one has the Schrader valve in place and the other one's been removed, and you can see for yourself just how different the reading is. So the first test we'll do is without the Schrader valve in place. And we get a total of 70 psi. And now with the hose that has the Schrader valve installed, we are 150, 60, 75. The difference is incredible, and you can actually see now why it's so important to have one. And my friend's dropped his kit over for me to install one of those valves and show you how to do so at home too. So the tools that you need, and I've added links to them in the description below for you, are of course your compression test adapter, a 4.2 millimeter drill bit, a 4.5 millimeter drill bit, a 5V136 tap, a Schrader valve install tool, and of course your low pressure Schrader valve too. And I recommend you avoid converting these metric drill bit sizes to the imperial equivalents. I've spent a lot of time measuring and checking that valve seal diameter and how and where it sits on that step that we're forming. Therefore, they're very specific sizes, and you may end up with a leaking valve if you try and convert them to the imperial equivalent. So I actually created a cross section of what your adapter is going to look like when it's finally completed. And essentially where the two different drill sizes meet creates a step. And that step is where the seal will rest against on the Schrader valve. And when it's done correctly, the tip of the Schrader valve is protected as well. Now I'm going to do this process on a lathe, but of course you can do it just as well and just as accurately on a pillar drill, or even just a hand drill and a vise if you're careful. So the first step is to actually drill through the whole of the adapter with the 4.2 millimeter drill bit. However, for me, this adapter actually came with exactly that size. Now, if yours doesn't and it's larger than this, you can simply fill the hole with solder and drill it through. Next, we drill a 4.5 millimeter hole, 10 millimeters or 3/8 of an inch deep from the side that actually goes into the cylinder. Lastly, use that tap to create the threads, which also forms the correct angle for the valve to seat against. And that's it, you're done. It really is that simple. However, it's worth noting, if you don't get those two drill holes correctly aligned, you may get a slight leak on the shoulder that you've formed. You can simply add some gasket dressing compound to the Schrader valve threads, and that's sealed too. And if you don't own a compression tester already, or you're not interested in modifying yours, I've put links in the description below to one that I recommend and I know that's accurate. If you've enjoyed today's video and you like repairing engines yourself at home, there are 5 incredibly common mistakes that I see people make that I recommend that you avoid, featured in a video up here for you next.